All right, so you have less than $1,000 to spend and you want some type of audio solution in your house. I've got that solution for you, my friends. For well under $1,000, it's gonna kick the crap out of any home theater in a box or soundbar you can buy at the local stores like Best Buy or wherever you guys go shopping. So you gotta watch this video. It's key that you watch this. Hey folks, I'm Gene Della Sala with Audioholics. Glad you're back. I hope you're subscribing to this channel because we're going to give you a lot of tips here today. I'm starting a new kind of feature on Audioholics. We are integrating our YouTube channel and the website with Amazon. Unfortunately, because Amazon has taken over, so since you can't beat them, you might as well join them. So we started a Amazon influencer page on our site, and we're putting products into this Amazon influencer page. Most of the products in there are stuff that we've had personal experiences with. We've reviewed some of the stuff. You'll see links to the articles in our articles to Amazon when we have reviews and stuff like that. So we try to put products that we know are decent or a good value or good performers or that got really high value in the consumer index on Amazon page. So a common question I keep getting asked from people in emails is, hey, I got about $1,000 or less to spend on a home theater. What do you recommend? Well, we put together this article about a week ago and it's been wildly popular and I want to share this with you. And I think it's a great entry level system for a 5.1 system as a way to also upgrade. So it's a good start for you. I want to show you this. And here's a picture of basically the whole system in a nutshell. It's Dayton Audio speakers and subwoofer, a Denon receiver and a Sony Ultra HD Blu-ray player, and we got some generic cables and stuff like that in there. So I want to show you what we got going on here. Now, it was hard to find a receiver, a 5.1 receiver for around $250 that's 4K capable with the switching, and the prices go up and down on Amazon a lot. So I did find this Denon one, the AVR S540BT. Now, you also can be looking at other solutions as well. We've got Onkyo's got price receivers in this price range. Yamaha's got receivers in this price range. Pretty much, you know, in the $250 price range, most of these receivers are giving you the same feature set. These don't give you Atmos. You're not doing Atmos because this is a 5.1. So when I say 5.1, I mean you're going to have a left, center, right speaker, back and left surround and back surround and a subwoofer. So that's your 5.1. If you're spending this low of a budget, this is where you're going to be. You're not going to be doing height channels. We want to focus on the quality of your ear level channels. And that's why we went with this solution here. But this is the real star of the show here, the Dayton Audio MK402 bookshelf speaker and the MK442 center channel speaker. Now, here's the cool thing. This is the center channel, so it's an MTM. You have a 4-inch mid-range, a 1-inch tweeter, and a 4-inch mid-range again. And then this is the bookshelf, the 402. Same woofer, same tweeter. But what we found in our review of this system, and I'm going to show you that. Here's the actual review we did a while ago, and we have a lot of measurements in them. So the 402 bookshelf are $70 a pair, and the 442 center channel is $50 each. We're actually suggesting if you have the space, I would really suggest that you do a pair of the 442s vertically oriented as a stereo set for your main front, left and right channels. Because this MTM driver array really, it gives you more output, more sensitivity, more power handling, and just better sound. And it's a much more even response as well. Because when you put the speaker vertically mounted, it actually controls the dispersion, you know, from the ceiling and the floor. So it kind of tapers that down more, and it focuses the sound more towards the listening area. So I wanted to show you some pictures about that. And this is the speaker. You know, we've taken them apart. They've got really good quality drivers at this price, and you actually have a real crossover. You don't get real crossovers like this in inexpensive speakers. You can see there's an air core inductor here. There's a bypass polypro capacitor. And, you know, I think it's a second order crossover. So, I mean, it's got it's got the right parts. Everything in here, and I'm sorry, it wasn't a 1-inch tweeter, it was a 3/4-inch silk dome. So pretty close. So you can see the build quality on these speakers is really good. I wanted to see if I could find a picture. Here's where we're talking about, you're taking these speakers. This is the center channel now, and I'm suggesting that you use it as a left and right channel as well. So you're vertically mounting these speakers, and this becomes a killer stereo set when you do that. So imagine doing three of these for your front soundstage, your left, center, right. You've got perfect matching between the three speakers. You don't necessarily have to do vertical mounting for the center channel, because I realize that could block your TV, or you may not have your screen high enough to accommodate that. If you could do all three vertically mounted, that'd be great, especially if you're using like a transparent screen. Otherwise, do the center channel horizontal mounting, and then do the left and rights vertically mounted, and then use the 402s as surrounds. You could put them on a wall, or you could, you know, hang them up or put them on stands or whatever. So this is a serious speaker. Even though it's a cheap, inexpensive product, I mean, it measures pretty darn well. These are the 402s. These did have a little bit excessive treble in our measurements. That's why we were suggesting looking at the 442 if you could, because this thing just measures beautifully. I mean, you can see it here. This is just a great little speaker. This is a beautiful measurement right here. So this is just a nice speaker. Really recommend doing three of these in the front and then doing the 402s for your surrounds. So by doing three in the front, it's going to add about $30 to the total price of this package. So our $750 recommended system is going to go to $780. The other thing I recommend is, here's the Dayton Audio subwoofer. It's a 10-inch, 100-watt. It's a small sub. It's not an extreme bassaholic rating. It's definitely a small rated sub. But you're talking about an entry-level system here. And I would at least suggest getting one of these subs. If you have the budget, if you can spend $1,000 on this system, then I would tell you to get two of these subs, because two subs are always better than one. Do two of these subs, plug them into the Denon receiver, and then run these speakers as small with a crossover of about 80 hertz. And run the subwoofers, at the front of the room towards the front wall, a quarter placement on each side of the wall, 1/4, 3/4 kind of placement. We have diagrams on that I could show you. But if you're going to be able to do two subs, that'd be great. If you can't do the two subs, if you can't spend the extra $120, I'm actually going to tell you to run these speakers full range, at least for the front, left, and right, because you're going to need the extra bass punch from these speakers to kind of supplement the subwoofer. And they self-dampen enough, so you're not going to bottom the drivers out running them large. So I would definitely recommend running them large if you're only using one sub. But if you're going to use two subs, run them through bass management at around 80 hertz. So like I said, one sub if you want to do a bass system, but two subs is better if you could afford it, or you could do an upgrade path down the road. And then here's just the Ultra HD Blu-ray player from Sony. If you have a preference for another Blu-ray player, by all means, use that. But this is an inexpensive player. It rated pretty well. And then we just picked some speaker cables. You know, we like to use a 14-gauge speaker cable if you can. The lower the gauge, the lower the resistance. You don't need to go and put 10-gauge cable on these speakers. But 14-gauge is more than sufficient, and you've got $18 for 50 feet. That should give you plenty of cabling, at least for most of your speakers. If you need to run longer cables to the surrounds, then we would recommend you use CL2 rated cable if it goes behind drywall. CL2 has like kind of white or gray jacket, so it prevents it from catching fire. You know, it's just a much safer cable. It's certified to go behind drywall. And I could put some links for that as well in this video. And then we put some subwoofer cables and HDMI cables. I found this Twisted Veins pack. So you click on the link and it takes you to our Amazon page. So we do appreciate if you do use the links when you're purchasing these kind of systems. We get about a 4% commission. So it's definitely not going to make us rich or drive around in Ferraris. But it does pay the reviewers that are writing this content. You know, anytime you guys could help out, we appreciate that. So here's the breakdown of the system. There's a little tabulation here. You've got the Dayton Audio speakers. We're assuming you're using the bookshelves and then one center channel. Again, if you're going to use the two 442s for their left and right, and then one for the center, you're going to add about $30 retail here. And then if you're going to do two of the subwoofers, it would add another $120. So all in all, this is a well-rounded system. It's starting at $750 and topping off at around $900 to $1,000. This is definitely a soundbar and home theater in a box killer. Let me just tell you something. Soundbars are great if you're in a pinch and you don't have a way to put discrete speakers around the room. I'm not bashing soundbars. But you do have to spend a considerable amount of money to get a good soundbar that's got a lot of output, that does good virtualization of surround sound. It's hard to get one for under $1,000 it's definitely not going to perform as well as this for music. It might sound good for movies and everything, but ultimately, if you care about music, this system is really geared towards music listening. Great for home theater listening as well. But our focus on Audioholics is always music first. So getting a discrete speaker system, a 5.1 speaker system like this, is definitely going to do you justice to your music, especially when you're listening to Blu-rays that are in DTS HD, which is uncompressed audio. You're going to really thank us. You're going to like the sound of these speakers. I hope that you like this system. It's an entry-level system. We've got some older systems in the recommended sections of our site, and I'm going to show you that section real quick. And I'm going to be updating this throughout the year. So when you go to Audioholics, I think it's under AV Research. You go to AV Research, you hit Recommended Systems. And here you can see we've got a $2,500 5.1 system. This is probably a little outdated. I need to update it. But this is the section of the site where we're going to be putting together packages for your convenience. So whatever budget you're at, you can come here and kind of look at our suggestions. And I'm going to be trying to update these regularly. I know it's hard because some of these articles, when they're 3 or 4 years old, the equipment changes and it's obsolete. I will be putting some more resources towards that. So let me know what you guys are looking for. Do you have these Dayton Audio speakers? What's your budget? What would you like to see us cover for these kind of recommended systems? And do you agree? Do you think that for $750 that this is about the best system you're going to get, especially if it's in 5.1 like this and it's got discrete speakers and a receiver? I like having a receiver because you could do all your HDMI switching. So I think it's a really well-balanced system. I'm curious to see what your take is, what your solutions are. Give us some examples down below. If you agree with this video, please thumb it up. If you don't agree, that's fine. Give us some alternative selections down there. I'm always open to changing things and upgrading. So I hope you enjoyed this video. And until next time, my friends, keep listening.